The Blue Jays, as we mentioned, playing a charter member of the American League back in 1901. The Chicago White Sox played the very first game in the American League. Now they're going to introduce the starting lineups. The 48th Highlanders marching on in the left field area. And we'll have some activities underway now. It looks as though they're going to give it a real try to get this ball game underway. The snow is certainly eased up considerably. It's just the white stuff on the field that's the problem. Let's see how well they do. The first man coming up is Ralph Garr, the left fielder for the White Sox, who's hit 300 or better in four of his six seasons in the major leagues. A 300 average in 1976. So Bill Singer will face a tough hitter, left-hander Ralph Garr.
And one of the fastest base runners in the American League, Don.
Here it is, the first pitch in Blue Jay history. It's a strike for the fastball. That ball has been exchanged and will go to the Canadian Sports Hall of Fame. Oh, and one the count as Singer deals again. Strike two.
Ralph Garr, Don, loves to play on artificial turf. He can get those high hoppers. Like I said, he's very fast getting down to first base, and he usually hits the ball on the ground a lot, tries to hit that ball through the infield. Once in a while, he'll crank up and hit a home run for you.
Singer is outside. It is 1-2. Well, you talk about his speed. The first time he stole a base in the major leagues, he stole home plate.
He can run. Probably not a good base steal like a Bill North with Oakland, but every bit is fast, and he's a definite threat to steal a base when he gets on.
32-year-old Bill Singer, a veteran I think best known for his days with the Los Angeles Dodgers, the first named player to be signed by the Blue Jays in the expansion draft, is pitching to Ralph Garr. It is 1-2. That's a ball that got away from Rick Cerrone. The count even now at 2-2. Coming up next, Alan Bannister, the shortstop, followed by George Order, the second baseman. 2-2 pitch. That bounces low. Gets away from Rick Cerrone again. Bill Singer, after two fast strikes, has run to a full count at 3-2. As he digs the mud out of his cleats, that'll be a problem for him, Whitey.
It is. They'll probably just leave something out there, usually some piece of metal where they can get that mud out of their spikes. Because when that fills up with mud, even with the spikes, it can be slippery, especially on the dirt portion of the field.
As Dave McKay in from third base with a word for Bill Singer, with a full count to Ralph Garr, the left fielder, 3-2. Outside, high, and it's a walk for Garr. Singer puts the first White Sox hitter on, and that'll bring up Alan Bannister, the shortstop. Bannister hit 248 in 1976. He's one of those great ball players out of Arizona.
Number
State.
Seven, Alan Bannister.
The left-hander Garr gets on with a base on balls, and now the first right-hander to face Bill Singer is Alan Bannister. Nobody out, top of the first inning, the White Sox and the Blue Jays in the snow in Toronto, inside for a ball.
You mentioned Alan Bannister. So many good players have come out of Arizona State. Duffy Dyer with Pittsburgh, Sal Bando, Reggie Jackson, Alan Bannister. Just some great pitchers come out of that college.
Makes a move, tries to get Garr. He's back in plenty of time at first base. Doug Ault covering the bag for the Blue Jays. 1-0 the count to Alan Bannister. Fouled off, first base side. There's the first souvenir to the stand. Tell you, base stealing, which Garr likes to do, could be a little treacherous on that slippery turf between first and second. He hasn't really made a move yet. 1-1, the count to Bannister. That is low and away for ball two. Two balls and a strike. Nobody out, top of the first. Ralph Garr on first base.
Bill Singer is a low ball pitcher, Don. He, in a case like this, he wants to pitch low to Alan Bannister to try and get that ground ball and see if they can get a double play.
A couple of previous pitches to Ralph Garr got away from Rick Cerrone. 2-1 count, goes for the bag at first and doesn't get it.
Bill Singer has a good move to first base for right-handed. Right-handed pitchers very seldom pick a runner off first, but he can hold him close.
That's pretty tight. That'll be ball three. 3-1. So Singer with a little control problem after dealing two strikes to start the top of the first inning. And remember, it's awfully cold out there. It's pretty hard to condemn a pitcher for letting his control get away on him on a day like this.
And as your fingers are cold, it's a little tough to get a grip on the baseball.
3-1 pitch. Gars away. Here's Sherrod, the throw to second base. He's safe and goes into the outfield. Gar will try third base. He's in there. Gar advances two bases on the pitch to Alan Bannister.
There goes Gar. He got a pretty good jump running off of that dirt.
Here it is again. Gar was shaken up coming around into third base.
The throw was a little low and got by the shortstop.
That slide, I think, hurt him. So Bannister flies to Steve Bowling. Bowling holds Gar. We have one out, and the batter is going to be George Orta, the second baseman.
The second baseman, George Orta.
Orta with a .274 average in 1976. Led the Sox in runs batted in. Game-winning hits, and he had the longest hitting streak for the team last year, 17 consecutive games. Left-hander against the right-hander Singer. It is popped up into center field. Gary Woods under it, has it. He will not get Ralph Gar. The long throw is cut off partially by Singer. Gar scores, and the White Sox go on top by a run. Cleanup man Richie Zisk, the right fielder, coming up now, number 22. Batted .313 in 1974, his best year. Hit .289 last year. One game against the Giants. He had a homer, triple, double, and single all in one ball game. Singer's pitch is low for a ball, ball two. 2-0 the count to Richie Zisk. Two away. White Sox lead 1-0 in the top half of the first inning of the first major league game ever in Toronto.
I think Bill Singer is having a little trouble with that mud getting in his spikes. He's been pitching a little higher than he usually does.
Solid ball hit deep to center field, about the 400 mark near the fence. It is gone for a home run. Richie Zisk, a 400-foot home run, and the Chicago White Sox are going to go on top 2-0. Richie Zisk. There's that power we talked about. So Bill Singer gives up the first home run in Blue Jay history.
Richie Zisk is used to playing in the ballpark like this. It's just about the same dimensions as the Pittsburgh Pirates field. 400 feet to center field, 375 in the alleys, just about the same distance. And Zisk is one of those hitters. Hits left center, right center, and dead center field.
This is Jim Spencer, the first baseman. First pitch is low from Singer for a ball. Two out. White Sox lead the Blue Jays 2-0, top of the first inning. 1-0 pitch on the ground into the outfield past Pedro Garcia. That's a base hit. That is the second hit given up by Bill Singer. The home run by Richie Zisk, and now the one base hit by Jim Spencer. There's seventh man to the plate now. Two runs on two hits. Singer pitches. That is hit foul down the third base side. The ball hops up into the crowd. Spencer will go back along with Oscar Gamble.
I finally got the number of the Blue Jay relief pitch pitched down to bullpen. It's 44, Jerry Johnson. Done.
Jerry Johnson likely to replace Singer, although Bill throwing a little better now, finding that strike zone, the count 1-2. Wants to get out of this inning if he can right here against Soderholm. Deals the 1-2 pitch. That is hit to the shortstop. Up with it is Torres to second base to Garcia, and the inning is over. And the Chicago White Sox get two runs on two hits. No Toronto errors. They lead it 2-0 after half an inning.
The left fielder, John Scott.
And here's John Scott coming up, the first batter in the very brief history of the Toronto Blue Jays. The first time they've come to the plate. John Scott, the left fielder. They sent nine right-handed batters up in this lineup against Brett. Scott hit 315 in a Y last year. He's a streak hitter. First pitch to him from Brett is a strike. Fastball for strike one. Scott was the first choice for San Diego in the free agent draft in 1970. This ball is fouled just to the left of the plate. So it is 0-2, two strikes to John Scott. Hector Torres, acquired from Cleveland recently. We'll be following him in. And here's something for all you trivia fans. And that is, if you want to remember in years to come who is the first man ever to hit for the Jays, it is indeed this man. You're watching it right now, John Scott. That was the ball, 1-2 the count to him. White Sox lead 2-0 over Toronto. We're in the bottom of the first inning. Inside, it'll go to 2-2.
Scott's an ideal leadoff man. He has good speed, can steal bases. I know manager Roy Hartfield is going to want to see this guy lead off the game, either a walk or a base hit many times this season. He's got real good speed and stole 38 bases last year.
White Sox shifted around to the left for John Scott, Blue Jays hitter. The count is 2-2. That is a third strike swinging, and he goes out. So you can also add to your trivia notes, the first man up struck out for the Toronto Blue Jays. Torrey certainly has been around, playing with Montreal, Houston, Chicago Cubs, and San Diego. Now, Toronto. 1-2 pitch to it. Inside, he went for it. Strikeout number two for Ken Brett. Striking out Scott and Torres. Now it'll be Doug Ault, the first baseman.
Number 25, the first baseman.
Usually after a strikeout, the catcher will throw it down to third and he'll throw it around the infield. But I noticed today it goes right down to the third baseman and back to the pitcher. When you get a two-run lead, you like to get that game over with as quick as you can and not delay it at all.
Doug Ault picked up from Texas in the expansion draft. Hit 313 for Sacramento in Texas last year, mostly with Sacramento. Brett had that pitch get away on him. It's a ball, 1-0. He joined them for nine games. There's Ann Murray. She sang the national anthem. Probably wondering about that big song of hers, Snowbird, after what's happened today. Ball one, strike one to Doug Ault. Blue Jays have struck out of their first two appearances. They trailed 2-0 to the Chicago White Sox. Brett deals, hard hit ball, power alley, left center field, home run! Doug Ault hits the first homer in Blue Jay history and will score the first run.
Don Bobby Durr, the batting coach for the Blue Jays, was telling me about Doug Ault during batting practice. Very strong. Hit that ball real well over the 375-foot sign and probably went close to 400 feet.
What a thrill for this crowd. There he is, Doug Ault, hard-hitting first baseman. This crowd roaring like a World Series crowd. Here's the cleanup man, the designated hitter, Otto Velez. Strike one. Velez with the Yankees hit 266. Got about 100 at-bats, I think it was, last year, Whitey. Second pitch to him. That is high for a ball. It is 1-1.
I've pitched batting practice out of Velez for probably the last 3 years. He's got good power to all fields, and he can hit that ball over that right field fence as easy as that left field fence. He's got good power to the opposite field.
Brett's pitch is inside. It is 2-1. He's one of two Yankee members of the American League champions last year with the Blue Jays. Jim Mason is the other. Mason hit a home run in the World Series. That is going out to center field. Scrambling back forward is Chet Lemon. He's got another warning track for the third Blue Jay out. The two long balls hit, one for a home run by Doug Ault. Deep fly ball to center by Otto Velez. And the Blue Jays end their first inning with a run on a hit. And the score is Chicago 2 and Toronto 1.